So, but how does he, like, how are you auditioning people? As a writer?
As a writer, yeah.
Oh, so, fuck, I didn't
so,
even like...
So, yeah, I came to Bombay to write my first TV show, which was Sada Hak on Channel B. Which was set in an engineering college. They thought that, you know, they'll get real life insights. And before that, I thought television, it has no writers.
Right.
I thought that there's a director who actors ko ek frame mein lata hai, kata, aap ye bol do, and it's done. I was so disconnected. I was like, oh, so someone writes it and someone gets, you know, get paid good money for it, because the only place where writing has money is television.
Yeah.
So television writers have a lot of money.
Yeah.
Which I realized later. So
like after writing or before writing?
No, after writing. After signing my contract, which was for very little money. And I talked to other writers, they said, cut gaya. And I signed a 3-year long contract.
Oh shit, dude. But kitne episodes hai 3 saal mein?
Lord, like 700-800 episodes.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Yeah.
Matlab total?
Total, yeah. Home. And I was writing other series as well. So I lost out on a lot of money in those 3 years. But at that point in time, I thought that this is not my,
No, so 3 years, I mean, every year, it's daily.
It's a daily. So 5 episodes a week, which is 250 episodes into 3, which is
700 episodes.
Yeah. But there are episodes where, so you have to write a party episode and you want your money and you do not want to, like, invest a lot of your brain power. So you write an entire episode of people getting ready for that party. So 20, but it's also all of television is like that aaj aap likhoge, aaj raat ko episode, dialogue wala dialogue likhega, kal wo shoot hoga. So no one has any time to react on what you have written. So you can write the most insane shit that
you but 700 episode kar raha, then though it can be like,
no, see,
you have to focus on such like party ke liye taiyari. One episode is just receiving the invite.
So my analogy is that Game of Thrones ke writer 8th season nahi likh paaye. You can't expect us to write 22 minutes of good content every day.
Right.
For fraction of that money.
You didn't get paid as much as the Game of Thrones guy.
I wouldn't be.
Don't lie. No, by the way, you guys are responsible. So, main channel mein kaam karta tha, theek hai? So I was a fucking horrific writer. I mean, I still am, but that time also I was. And so I was writing. Oh, by the way, cheers to this great coffee that we have. Yeah. Stop. So I was writing that time.
Slightly cold though.
Yeah, it's that cold kind of coffee which we get, you know, nowadays. What do they say? Sleepy hour.
Cold brew.
Cold brew, huh? Yeah, cold brew. Hai. Very cold brew. We've reduced the coffee amount because of like organic reasons. So I was working at Channel V and we used to write all this bullshit. And then suddenly we are like shows like Sadhaak aur ek tha na wo love dosti dance,
love dosti no dil dosti etc.
D3
yeah, it's called D3.
D3
it's called D3, yeah.
So you wrote for that also, what?
No, so I think Sadhaak was the last big show of Channel V. So when we came, we sort of decimated all the shows. And then they realized channels hi koi nahi dekh raha, because young people are also watching soaps, because there's one television, one remote, kids don't have any autonomy.
Yeah,
so they just like phased out fiction from youth shows, youth channels. So yeah, we were the last few shows that.
But you guys, your ratings, you pushed the ratings up of channels.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, we did. In those,
like I remember I was discussing this with Mandira also, where it's like, us time pe hamare like the average ratings of like good shows were like 7 point whatever. And we were like, yaar, tera show to bahut acha kya hai, 0.1 we got.
Like, no, so we pushed it to around 1, which was insane.
That's a lot, man.
Which was insane at that point in time. And that's why, so like Sadhaak still remains, my first show still remains like, oh, these guys wrote Sadhaak. So it still remains like one of my high points of my television career. After that, I've written for bad shows, mostly bad shows.
What is Sadhaak about?
Sadhaak is about a girl who goes to an engineering college and patriarchy. So we were on that bandwagon quite early. So a lot of shows tried to ape it. And we were like, karna hai to hame hi paise de dete hain, hame likh dete fir se agar same hi karna hai to mai to. But yeah, it was fun.
Who are the people who tried to ape it?
No, so Star Plus came with a bunch of shows. So we made ki ek ladki ko engineer banna hai. They said, acha ab ladki ko pilot banna hai. Ladki ko athlete banna hai. So they just started exploring different professions. that is the only change that they made.
It's like, who's your writer? It's a career consultant.
It was just that.
But was it like the pilot episode written by somebody who's formerly a pilot? Or koi, matlab, tukka maarke?
No, so my co-writer was a liberal arts undergrad from Symbiosis deciding things. So we have done stuff. So the second season of Sardahak was these guys planning to go to space. And not just like space, Mars.
Oh, the students?
The students. And it was written by me. And a liberal arts undergraduate. So, koi, aur wo, and we have shown stuff like, ki, achha, oh, so the girl, so in Star Plus, in like all the big channels, you have to make a character diamond. Ki, huh. What is the...
Character diamond.
Like what five characteristic traits does this character like really exhibit? So one was smartly manipulative.
Smartly manipulative, wow.
So she had to exhibit that in every episode in some way or the other. So... सेल फोन नहीं चल रहा बैटरी कैसे चार्ज होगी घिस दो दीवार से बैटरी चार्ज होगी एंड देन वी हैड गर्ल्स इन ट्राइपॉड टेकिंग आउट बैटरीज ऑन देयर फोन एंड लाइक रबिंग अगेंस्ट द वॉल
दैट्स हिलेरियस
सो यार वी हैड टू कम अप विद स्टफ लाइक दैट
बट ये स्पेस वाला एपिसोड तो क्या हुआ उसमें एंड वो स्पेस वाला सीजन पूरा सीजन वाज लाइक
पूरा सीजन वाज अबाउट दैट
वाओ So did they get to space and then she reaches there and there also she faces
sexism? So there was this capsule which used to continue to shake in every episode and it was like a simulation and then it didn't happen and then it was like just parties.
No, so I'm trying to understand, okay, okay. So those people are studying in engineering college and then somebody is like, bhai, apan log Mars jaate hain.
No, engineering college se wo pass out ho gaye.
Achha, pass out ho gaye.
Pass out ho gaye. So engineering college ka big final was that they made a car and it won some formula, whatever, one race. And now they have gone their other ways. And India requires the topmost mechanical engineers to create a shuttle to go to Mars. And somehow all these people come back together. And then they try to make the shuttle. So yeah, it's
direct, man. Like, ISRO ko pura bypass kar liya tum logne.
It was, I mean, so at one point in time, when we were really short of stories, we thought that we'll keep a secret society who has sort of identified these brilliant students in this engineering college and we named it Freemasons. So Freemasons is like an actual society.
Yeah, obviously. Huh.
But hamare dimag mein tha ki haan, wo toh mostly fictionally hai. So we use the name Freemasons.
Are you serious?
Yeah. And then our programming had to go to Kolkata and like we have to beep out all references to Freemasons because someone from the Freemasons had said that we are not like this. We do not take blood out of young students, put them on a pen drive and say, haan, iska DNA usse match ho raha hai.
Second. So you take some blood and put it on a
pen drive and the result comes immediately. Like you know the ancestry of the entire family. Wow. So we have done that.
That's amazing. But that's fun.
Yeah, that's see, at that point in time it was all very spur of the moment because you know when every Thursday the ratings used to come and we used to have a panic meeting.
Huh.
Nothing is working, what should we do? What is the next story? And now as writers, you can't say that we do not know what's going to happen. So sitting there, we have to construct the story as we are speaking.
Okay, let's try that, okay? Yeah, ratings are not working. We don't know what to do. Currently, what's really hot is the sun. Can we do something around the sun?
So, because you're saying sun, I'll give you a real life incident. So, the thing was that we are auditioning for a show that's like really highly rated and usme tha ki apna ladka so any soap when the guy and the girl they sort of stop fighting the show ends
right
so they said okay so the sun's not working because he's not fighting anymore so now we have to shift the focus into the saas and the bahu so what can we do so the story that we suggested was that to ghar ke zawara chori ho jate hain और सीसीटीवी में आता है कि एक सांप गया था तिजोरी में ही रैप्ड अराउंड दैट डायल खोला जवाहरात लिया और भाग गया सो नाउ सो द फर्स्ट देयर सजेशन वाज दैट लेट्स कीप दैट द गर्ल has sort of colluded with a ring of Sapiras.
Huh.
And they said, we don't think that it's, you know, shocking enough.
Huh.
So we came up with this thing that the Saas says that Bahu, tu hi ichhadari nagin hai.
Oh, ho, ho.
You are the snake yourself. So I'll call a Sapera and try to turn you into a snake so that you reveal your true self.
So the Saas is saying ki tune chori kiya.
Haan, so initially there was like, try to make something like there is a snake, thief ring, but we think that it's not shocking enough because everyone else is doing animals.
Haan.
So what animal can you bring to our show?
Or this was before like Nagin and everything.
This was Nagin chal raha tha, but there were other people who were getting gorillas in their shows.
Haan.
So they were like, we need an animal of our own.
Haan.
So we said, okay, let's bring in snake. So a snake thief ring sort of came in and then we said, Ichhadari Nagin lekar aate hai. Even this is not shocking enough. And then we said, achha, but this is the farthest that we can go. So then we gave up.
Oh, you didn't go further, like, achha, wo actually penguin hai. Like,
try you can't, other you can't put cute stuff.
You can't put cute, it has to be something dangerous.
It has to be, yeah.
Oh, scorpion nahi, wo to bichu wagera hua hai. So, what else is dangerous? Dude, Nagin is, I can't stop talking about that show.
That is brilliant.
It's just next level.
You can't beat that show.
Yeah, and like people are
actually,
like,
I was, you know Samit Basu?
Of course. Huh.
So we are trying to make a good Nagin show. Huh. So we made...
Oh, there is a good Nagin show. It's called, I'll tell you the name, Ichha Pyari Nagin.
Oh, that is on Sub.
Yeah. So that she's like a good Nagin and she's like...
No, Nagin. But like a good as in, like a... good fantasy show.
Huh.
Not like.
Are you trying to say that Ichha Pyari Nagin was not a good show?
No, it was a funny show.
I think it was a great show and I think you should take your words back. First of all, it starts with the pun of Ichha Pyari Nagin.
Yeah, I agree. But we were trying to make a fantasy show, so they thought that, okay, we'll get a fantasy writer who's Samit Basu, who comes from a very Western school of thought of fantasy, and he's like an intelligent guy. And the show was Nagarjuna, ek yodha ki kahani. So he came up with brilliant stuff and I was a part of all those meetings. Yahan se portal khulta hai, wahan se portal khulta hai. These guys come in, these guys are like men who transform into... And the channel did not understand anything. And I used to follow Samit Basu on Twitter.
Yeah.
And he used to like slyly tweet about all those things. And I was like, achha, unke baare mein bol raha hai. And then he finally gave up. And then they made it into a show which was like a poor copy of Nagin.
Huh.
But I could feel... You know, when you're a writer like me,
huh,
who's like, haan, paiso ke liye kuch bhi likh
dege, huh.
I can take it with a pinch of salt. Huh. But when it's Samit, who can't think like that, I can really like, I enjoy that frustration. Ki, what is this world that I am in?
Yeah, and Samit Basu is not like, he's not going to take it down. Like, he's like,
yeah,
hey,
yeah,
kaise,
he's like, matlab, see, Samit Basu is like a Bengali. He doesn't need a lot of money to survive.
Yeah.
So he'll not take a lot of shit. And he'll give it back. And I'm like, haan, ye bahut sahi hai.
Main likhega.
So,
but did they get confused about portals and all? Kya hota hai, wo sab cheez? Or like even more basic stuff? Because there's two attitudes. One to attitude ye hoti hai ki bhai audience ko samajh mein nahi aa raha hai, ya dusri attitude ye hoti hai ki mujhe samajh mein nahi aa raha hai. So which one, or was it a combination of
both? It was a combination of both, because see, people who have been working in the TV industry for that long, they are the audience now.
Yeah.
So like even web series, why it doesn't like cross over to that Netflix, Amazon ka, is because most of the TV people are now commissioning shows for web.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So when I go for web series ka narration, I see the same faces. Jisko maine ek concert becha tha ki achha, ek western dancing group hoga, ek Indian dancing group hoga, usme patriarchy hogi, kisi ke baap ka chacha mar gaya hoga, kisi ne... So it's the same guy who's listening to now my web series about a mature couple who's trying to have a kid. So I know that they are not going to make something path breaking.
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah.
That's damn interesting. But you wrote for so much of the stuff. That's what, like, I think you get all these jokes are not targeted at you, which I think everybody does in the public sphere. But I think what people don't understand is the work. Like, tu 3 saal ke liye ek show ke liye likha, and then you've been like pitching here and there and doing all this crazy stuff.
Yeah,
and so it's a lot of work, man.
No, but the most insulting is that that when these people who are working for web, they come up to me and say that, you know, there's this book that we have heard about.
Yeah.
Why don't you come and pitch it to us?
Huh.
And I have already... So one thing is that creatively, I've already had a lot of fun with the book.
Huh.
You know, I've sort of extracted everything that I could out of the book. Now I have to go there and pitch it and tell them why it is a bestseller, it becomes like very insulting. So I'm like, mujhe nahi kar raha. I would rather pitch you a new concept.
Right.
So it's
Is it like convince us it's a bestseller?
Convince. Why? Why did it work? And the thing is that most of my books are now the same in my head. They were already same. There's a girl and a boy and they fall in love and blah, 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 blah. So there have been times that I have gone to a meeting and said that how many books have you written? I've said 16. Narrate all of them.
Are kitna time hai aapke paas?
No, kitna time se bhi zyada. Mere dimag mein everything is a khichdi, everything is the same.
Right.
So I'm like, main nahi kar sakta. Like, mere liye sab same hai.
But it's a lot of money, you know. But also you get stuck in that development, which is like a long process.
See, once you... So now my thing is that if the show is on air for 50 episodes, now I can come in.
Hmm.
Now I can go and write the screenplay where there's no feedback, etc., etc., etc. And now I can work.
Hmm.
But even then, it's not very creatively satisfying, but you can't say no to the money.
So you're still writing for TV?
On and off. Not so much now. Not so much now. Earlier I used to, not so much now. Because now you have web series, so you think that, you know, you can work for 3 months and get the same amount of money and not slog for the entire year.
So you wrote for that show, then you've written for many more shows, many more TV shows.
I've written for Veera, I've written for Million Dollar Girl, I've written
Million
for...
Dollar Girl is about... That's a web series, no?
No, that's a that's another show that came on Channel V about a girl who takes over her father's...
And she wants to be a millionaire or some... That's the story, that's the premise of
And she wants to do that by selling saris.
अच्छा
सो बिकॉज़ बनारस में सेट था कलर चाहिए था एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा
कलर चाहिए टोन अच्छा
हां कलर सो अ लॉट ऑफ इट इज दैट कि अच्छा हमें कहां किस सिटी में सेट करना है उसके हिसाब से कैन यू चेंज द स्टोरी
ओ दैट हैपेंस अ लॉट
दैट हैपेंस अ लॉट दैट हैपेंस अ लॉट सो नेवर किस योर बेस्ट फ्रेंड व्हिच इज माय लेटेस्ट वेब सीरीज इज
व्हाट इज इट कॉल्ड
नेवर किस योर बेस्ट फ्रेंड
अच्छा
सो इट वाज इनिशियली सो इट्स मेड आउट ऑफ अ बुक Of my co-writer. It was set in Chandigarh, but they were getting like a thing in London. So we suddenly shifted the story to London.
Very convenient.
Yeah. So everything is much richer now. So that happens a lot.
Dude, I have a friend of mine who makes ads. And he's like, my client ko jaake pitch karta hai ki, bhai, whatever, hamara parag paan masala hai. And we want some foreign setting. So I just go through the map and figure out ki kahan pe mujhe jaane ka hai. And he's like, I call him, I'm like, dude, where? He's like, bro, Estonia. Estonia, let me shoot kar raha hai. So did you have to go to London to...
No, my co-writer did. I wanted to go, but then family, etc. So I couldn't go. Plus it's so cold.
Haan, wo bhi hai.
So I was like, if you shoot the season 2 during the summers, I'll come.
Extra writing inputs.
So
you wrote those two. Fir iske baad abhi Never Kiss Your Best Friend.
Yeah.
About it, and that's
but my biggest show was, I think, like most loved was Kuch Rang Pyar Ke Aise Bhi, which came on Sony. So it was like a show which was half decent, like which is saying something. Like it was watchable. Like even when I used to watch it, I was like, this is not that bad. At least for the first 100-150 episodes, it was quite watchable. So, but it didn't. It never gave us very high TRPs, but everyone in the channel and a bunch of people who used to watch it, they used to be like, you know, this is a show which is still okay. So that is one of my, the only television achievements, which is Kuch Rang Pyar Ke Aise Bhi.
You've won awards for TV
for
writing?
For TV, a couple of them. But
you won something, I remember.
I think for Sada Hug, I remember. We did. It did, but it's
no, but it's I still find it so impressive. You seem to enjoy the process, and I think it's a smarter thing to go like, yaar, mujhe malum hai tum log ko kya chahiye, and I will conform to what your norms are, as opposed to going like, mujhe ye banane ka hai.
No, see, if you're a very brilliant writer, and you think everything that's happening around you is stupid, it's very hard for you to work. In that environment. But if you think that, अच्छा, तुम खुद भी average हो, यहाँ पे सब कुछ average चल रहा है, और ये average से ही खुश है. Then you're okay. Because, see, writing a book also gets very lonely and it's very solitary. But when you're writing for television, there are a lot of people around, there's conversation and bakchodi happening all the time. So you're like, haan, kar lete hai. Like, it's fun.
Yeah.
So I treat it like that.
That episode gave me a lot of Durjoy. Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm retiring from comedy tomorrow. If you enjoyed this, please subscribe on YouTube if you're watching this. Lots more podcasts coming up. And again, please come see me do stand-up comedy live, because that's where I actually make money. Sorabhpant.com is tickets. I might be coming to your city soon. Thanks a lot for watching. And in the comments, let me know who you think I should interview next. Bye, have fun, and say hi to your parents for me.